So let's build on our sleep foundation. We learned about what sleep is and the fact that it is definitely not optional, nor is it just a period of inactivity or a temporary coma. Since it's such an active, complex state, there must be a process that controls when it occurs. With this said, we probably can agree that most of us tend to develop a sleep-wake pattern where we're awake during the day and asleep at night. Perhaps you have heard this pattern called a circadian rhythm, frequently referred to as your body clock. People associate this rhythm with a hormone our body makes called melatonin. Melatonin is produced in your brain in response to the absence of light, specifically the wavelength of blue light. This happens when your eye begins to perceive a reduction in light, which informs a part of your brain called the suprachiasmatic nucleus that you're being exposed to dim light or darkness, which then tells the pineal gland, hey, time to make melatonin. Many think that this is the main factor that controls our ability to fall asleep. Unfortunately, based on this belief, many people will use melatonin supplements when they struggle to sleep, and sometimes in excess. So much so that the Poison Control Center has reported a 600% increase in poison control calls due to too much melatonin ingestion. So if it's not all melatonin, what else is there to know about the circadian rhythm? The circadian rhythm is a near 24-hour cycle that we are pretty much programmed to follow. What do I mean by programmed? No, we're not robots. Well, over the last half a century, tremendous genetic discoveries occurred, where independently, several research groups identified genes and molecular mechanisms that direct the circadian pattern. And these genes are present in every cell of your body. This was such a monumental discovery that three of the researchers, Jeffrey C. Hall, Michael Rosbach, and Michael W. Young, received the Nobel Prize in 2017 for their discoveries leading to an improved understanding of these genes and the self-regulated molecular process that directs the circadian rhythm. It is important to point out that these same genes are also why some people or families may be more likely to be a night owl or a morning lark, meaning that they may feel more alert in the early morning hours or late night hours because of these subtle differences in genetically determined circadian patterns. It is important to know that many of us may have other things that can influence our circadian patterns, such as late night eating, scrolling on our cell phones in bed, bright light exposure at any inappropriate times of day, or even school or work schedules. Sometimes these factors can result in pathologic circadian rhythms called circadian rhythm disorders. If you want to learn more about these disorders, go to our section about circadian rhythm disorders. Now, as interesting and exciting as the circadian rhythm may be, it's not the only factor that matters in when you are awake and when you're asleep. It is actually matched up with another process that is referred to as the homeostatic sleep drive. When talking about the circadian rhythm and homeostatic sleep drive, we frequently refer to these as process C and process S. Process C for circadian rhythm and process S for homeostatic sleep drive. Your homeostatic sleep drive, also called sleep pressure or sleep load, is a process that increases your desire to sleep throughout the day. Process S is in fact what is responsible for making you fall asleep, but it acts in concert with process C. How? When looking at this figure, it provides an illustration of what a normal, healthy sleep-wake pattern would look like in an older adolescent or adult, where 8 hours may be sufficient duration of sleep. You can see that in the morning, both processes are low and they begin to rise. Process S is responding to increased production of factors that want to put you back to sleep. And if it was left up to that alone, you would struggle to stay awake. You may be wondering, what is it that is making us want to go back to sleep from the time we're waking up, or is controlling our homeostatic sleep drive? Well, the main answer is something called adenosine. Adenosine is an important component of our main energy that we use in our brain and body, called adenosine triphosphate, or ATP. As we burn through our ATP, this creates more of a drive to fall asleep. This is why caffeine temporarily makes us more awake, because it's an adenosine blocker. Process C, on the other hand, is promoting wakefulness. You can see across the day the two processes balance one another, allowing you to stay awake until late afternoon, early evening, when it begins to get dark and melatonin starts to be produced. This results in a change in direction of process C and starts creating a gap between the two processes, resulting in both of them agreeing we should go to sleep. Ultimately, when these two processes reach a maximum difference, it allows us the sleep gate to open, meaning that the homeostatic sleep drive can put us to sleep. It is important to note, however, that the homeostatic sleep drive gets paid back pretty quickly, almost halfway through the night. This is where melatonin we produce helps keep us asleep for the rest of the night and ultimately gets shut off in the early morning to allow you to wake up ready to start the day. Do you feel like your sleep cycle may be off? Are you sleeping at the wrong hours and feeling tired, not refreshed, or not getting enough sleep? Here are some things you can do to help. First, be mindful of things that can influence your circadian rhythm. No, you can't change your genetics, but you can strategize around light exposure, timing of meals, medications, and other things. Make sure you start your morning with lots of light and eating a nutritious breakfast to help promote wakefulness. During the day, keep active with school, work, or other activities, making time for lunch and a snack. In the evening, have dinner early enough that there are a few hours to spare before bedtime, and start your wind down routine, reducing light exposure and screen time, and create a cool, quiet, comfortable sleep oasis. Don't forget about your homeostatic sleep drive too. In addition to your wind down routine at night, avoid caffeine or other wake promoting substances late in the day that will block your drive to falling asleep. Keep a regular sleep schedule and make sure you are not oversleeping. Sleeping in, although sometimes feels great, will reduce the opportunity for your homeostatic sleep drive to build up enough to allow you to fall asleep easily that night. Still struggling despite these tips? Check out some of our other resources to get more information on sleep scheduling, bedtime routines, and tracking your sleep. If you are still struggling, use one of our screeners to help guide you. And don't forget, talk to your doctor about your concerns.